Hey guys, this is Ultimate Gaming Squad. In this video, I'm going to be completing one of the flashback challenges. Hope you enjoy.
Five here, and it goes on and on. On second down, here's Rodgers. Out to the left here, the lead. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down.
Teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. On the sneak, Rodgers. Call it a 3-yard gain, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches.
For those vertically challenged quarterbacks, here's a time where they will tell you it's an advantage to be a little bit on the smaller side, able to duck in behind their offensive line and stick the ball across the imaginary yellow line for a first down.
Charles, the lone setback. Now they'll run it on the toss. Got a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. And quickly, they get to the line. Now they'll run it on the toss. Able to get away.
Get the legs churning.
And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs. So the offense has it first and 10. He'll look to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Sonny Fox has rewatched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there.
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? Rodgers will throw for it. Steps away to his left. And he is into the end zone as that pushes the lead up to six. Now after the touchdown, Drew Kazer to boot it away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And now back down comes the offense. They have the lead, still a one possession game, but the defense got this. Now hang on here, timeout called by the defense. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Again, it's Charles. He finds some open field here. And a cutback, right sideline. And he takes this one down.
Say this from experience, especially from a defensive back's perspective, nothing's more terrifying than a toss sweep or a pitch play.
And this is picked up by the Browns, and his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
When you think of Jamal Charles, you think of speed, pure lightning, absolutely electric, and sometimes with those speed guys, the ball can get away from their body a little bit when they're carrying it, and some fumbles can result.
Got it loose there. Back to throw. Now a desperation throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted.
Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos. Follow me on social media. And once again, thanks for watching.